to fax Art Bell in the Kingdom of Nye, dial area code 702-727-8499. That's area code 702-727-8499. Please limit faxes to one or two pages. This is Coast to Coast AM with Art Bell.
It is. Good morning, everybody. We're about to do something that may offend you. We're going to have a real witch on. Or maybe you'll say she isn't a real witch. Maybe you'll say she's a devil worshiper. I don't know. We'll find out. But if this sort of thing offends you, tune out now. This is your absolute warning. Tune out now. Otherwise, hang tight, and we'll all learn something together, I suspect. And we've got several announcements coming up. Saturday morning at 10 o'clock, I am going to do the only book signing I'm ever going to do for The Quickening. It's going to be in Encinitas. Every now and then I say another city by mistake. Escondido. It's not Escondido. It's Encinitas. And it's going to be at Barnes & Noble in Encinitas at 1040 North El Camino Real. Now, it is a brand new bookstore, so fear not if you have checked a map, which some people have, and haven't found it. Be assured, it is indeed there, and one of the largest Barnes & Noble bookstores in all of California. So, there it is at 1040 North El Camino Real. There I will be at 10 a.m. sharp on Saturday morning. My suggestion is to be there early. Now, I will sign books for no less than 10 hours. They will then put my hand, possibly my entire arm, in a cast and carry me away. But for 10 hours, I will definitely personally sign books. Now, the reason this may be important is because it is the only time I am ever going to do it. All right. Just before we go to our witch question mark, we're going to Denver very quickly for an announcement from Tim Cannon. Now, Tim Cannon, I think, is there have been elections in the Art Bell Chat Club organization, and Tim is now some sort of international. What are you, Tim?
International coordinator, Art, and the founder of the Art Bell Chat Club.
Well, of course, the founder, but I wasn't quite sure of what the international title was, and we are international now because I know we've got a chat club in London.
That's correct.
And that's good because we may soon be heard in London. Anyway, what's going on with the chat clubs?
Well, lots of things. We're looking at some spots up in Canada, and I've been working closely with Keith Rowland, and Keith is going to be putting, I imagine it's already up by now, the information about all the chat clubs, their locations, the coordinators for each chat club, along with a phone number in that area that they can, that listeners can contact their coordinator and find out when the next meetings are going to be.
Okay. Is there a phone number, a general phone number now for those who want to either coordinate or start chat clubs?
Sure. We've got a number here in Denver. We'll get back to you on that. That's 303 area code.
Right.
767. 1778.
1778.
And we'll have someone return your call. And I want to take just a minute to thank Bob and Sue Crane, who's been really great sponsors of the chat club and supportive, Alan Corbis and David Masters up at the network, and, of course, yourself and Keith Rowland, who's worked very closely. We're celebrating here in the next week our first-year anniversary of the first chat club here in Denver, which meets at the Rising Phoenix Bookstore twice a month. And some of the guests that we've had, for those new listeners who are not familiar with what we do, basically we try to bring on lots of the guests that you've had on the show in person, and they come in and speak to us, and you have the opportunity to meet those guests and ask questions and listen to their presentation. We've had David John Oates, of course, Jose Escamilla, Ron Russell, Victoria Lillenquist, Alan Meese, Joyce Riley, along with many others. Keith Rowland is scheduled at our Phoenix Club here real soon, so if you'd like to get out and meet Keith, you need to contact the Phoenix Club, and get the information about
Keith is going to be a guest at the Phoenix Club?
Yeah.
Ha, ha, ha.
That'll be terrific. But
I'd like to go down and see that myself.
You'd like to see that yourself, huh?
Yeah.
Well, we do have a chat club in Las Vegas, and, of course, Los Angeles, Portland, Denver, all over the country now. And we're real proud of the first one that sprang up here in Denver at the Rising Phoenix. And tonight we've all gathered listening to this show. The first hour was great with Michael Holm and celebrating the 24th birthday of Curtis Miller, one of our chat club members and a great fan of yours. And so they've kept the bookstore open a little late so we can all gather and have a great time.
Well, Saturday is going to be my day at a bookstore.
Well, I'll tell you what, I was at the last one, and if it's going to be anything like the book signing up in Portland, it's going to be quite an event.
Yes, it should be something. Well, listen, my friend, let me get the number out again for anybody interested in forming a chat club or finding out, I guess, about the activities of the one in your area.
Okay.
It's area code 303.
767. 1778.
1778.
And we're all waiting for the witch, Art.
Well, your wait is over.
Okay.
Thanks, Tim.
Thank you, Art.
Bye-bye. That's Tim Cannon in Denver. Now, I have been getting faxes and email all day long from people saying, don't do it, Art. Don't do it. Don't do it. Whatever you do, don't do it. They've even been sending faxes to Ramona saying, don't let Art do it. I got a fax, which I will read, minus any identifying information. Hi, Mr. Bell. I am 32 years old. My cover name is Harlot. I am a witch of the most unholy kind. I am by no means a goddess. I use no crystal balls, tricks, nor treats. I am from a long line of witches and warlocks and so on. If you'd like to call me, she supplies the number. The Coven of the Unholy, hail Satan. Now let me say, Art, I am a good witch by no means. Even if I do something that someone would consider good, I do with evil in my heart. Hail Satan. Well, you guys know me. I will put anything on the air, and that includes Malachi Martin, Catholic priests, people of the cloth, people of the church, and people not of the church, and many things in between. So here is Harlot. Harlot, welcome to the program.
Thank you, Art.
How did you get your name Harlot?
I got my name Harlot because of how I live and what I do. I go around and I spread webs of deceit, and I adore myself in a very alluring fashion when I do these things. And I take great pleasure in finding a victim, laying my evil eyes upon him and bringing him into sinful joy. And if you go back into your scriptures and search them out, and especially in the Old Testament, a woman of my type would be called a harlot. And I take that strictly out of reference from biblical terms.
Okay. This fax, of course, shocked me and shocked a lot of people. A lot of people who have contacted me, Harlot, tell me you couldn't possibly be a witch.
I'm not surprised. I knew that that would be one of the first reactions when I sent the fax. What should I say, when my fiancé sent the fax? You know, for many years, it has been publicized in different newsletters and through television and through the media itself about what a witch is. If you search these things out, you will find out that even in the most medieval times, mm-hmm. that witches were of a more of an evil nature. We took great pleasure in setting great traps and being